Herb, congratulations on 20 years of Secular Humanists of the Low Country. I've had the pleasure of speaking there, and it's just a wonderful community that you've created. And in South Carolina, it's a very much needed one too. So thank you for that, and thank you for being such a great role model for me.
Hi, I'm Roy Speckhardt.
And I'm Maggie Ardiente.
And from all of us at the American Humanist Association, we want to send our best wishes to Herb Silverman on the 20th anniversary of the Secular Humanists of the Lowcountry.
Herb, thank you for your service as an AHA board member, for your wonderful and funny articles on the Washington Post, and for helping everyone at AHA conferences feel overdressed.
Congratulations to you, Herb, and best wishes to everyone on this anniversary conference.
Herb, not only are you a great humanist, but you're also a fine mathematician. Now, let's say you got to the pearly gates that you don't believe in, and St. Peter comes out and says to you, "You know, Herb, I know you don't believe in God, you've never needed God living your life, but I have a deal for you. If you can just answer one mathematical question, I'll still let you into the heaven you don't believe in. So here's the question. What's the square root of 1,543? A little too late. But you know, I can't send you to hell because you don't believe in that either. Congratulations on 20 great years in South Carolina's humanist community.
Hey Herb, Fred Edwards here, helping you celebrate 20 godless years in the Holy City. Holy City, that's a long time. But you and I, we go way back. So I think you should celebrate 20 more godless years in the Holy City. And after that, you should stop and let the younger ones do it for a while. In the meantime, I'm doing something that you do. I decided, in honor of this recognition, I'm going to wear a commemorative t-shirt. Just like you do. In this case, it's a t-shirt I got while speaking at the Pennsylvania State Atheist Humanist Conference, recently held in Pittsburgh. I'm wearing it in your honor.
Herb, you were instrumental in bringing this movement into the cooperative phase, and on behalf of American atheists, I want to thank you for all you've done for this movement and this country.
Hello, Herb. I'm here with this rather disturbing hand puppet from a Salvation Army Bible Camp program to say congratulations on your 20 years of leading the Secular Humanists of the Lowcountry. We celebrate many different Herb Silvermans. Herb the Humanist Leader, Herb the Church State Separation Activist, Herb the Fashion Plate, Herb the Educator, Herb the Author, Herb the Gubernatorial Candidate, and of course, Herb the Notary Public. Keep it up, Herb. We look forward to the next 20 years. What's that? He says, God bless you.
Hi, this is Dale McGowan from Foundation Beyond Belief. You know, a lot of people don't know that the Foundation's charitable giving model was directly inspired by the Charity of the Quarter program of Secular Humanists of the Lowcountry. SHL has always been one of my favorite freethought groups, and Herb Silverman has always been one of my favorite freethinkers, and I don't think that's a coincidence. 20 years ago, when SHL created Herb, I think some of their basic goodness and decency and sense of humor just rubbed off. So here's to 20 years, Herb, and a year from now you'll be able to lift a glass to your 21st.
Hello, Herb Silverman. Dave Niosi here with a call out from Massachusetts. Hey, congratulations on 20 years with Secular Humanists of the Lowcountry. And thank you, Herb, for everything you've done, not just in Charleston, of course, but all over the country. You've been spreading the good news of secularism everywhere you go. We're grateful to you for it. Keep up the good work and keep having fun, my friend.
Hi, I'm August Brunsman. I'm the executive director of the Secular Student Alliance, and I've known Herb since sometime in the late 90s, I think. I had the incredible experience of getting to watch close hand as Herb worked to get the Secular Coalition off the ground, but I'm sure lots of people are talking about how amazing all of that is. I wanted to say a little bit about how important Herb was in getting the Secular Student Alliance off the ground. Herb and Sharon were both early believers in the Secular Student Alliance, and their support in the first couple of years was really invaluable to getting it off the ground. Herb's done a million amazing things, and helping to get the SSA off the ground certainly wasn't the hardest, but it's changed my life and the lives of thousands of secular students. So thanks, Herb. You're amazing.
Like August said, Herb is definitely an amazing activist. And I've not known Herb quite as long, but I'm Amanda Metzkes, and I'm the executive director of Camp Quest and the president of the Secular Coalition for America now, which is a role that Herb had since its founding for many, many years. So I've gotten to work with Herb for a long time. And one of the things that I love about Herb is his infectious sense of humor. You know, sometimes activism can be exhausting and daunting and get you down, and Herb is always hilarious and fun and makes being in this movement a more friendly, exciting place to be, whether it's writing what is perhaps the most hilarious book in atheism, Candidate Without a Prayer, and using the hotel floor numbering scheme for the chapters, or telling what is my favorite Herb joke that I tell all the time, which is that when he dies, he's doing what his Jewish mother always wanted him to do. He's going to medical school. Those are the things that I think of when I think of Herb, in addition to his dedicated activism for years and years in this movement, is that he always makes it more fun. And so thank you so much, Herb, for all of your amazing hard work and all the laughs.
Yay, Herb.
Yay.
Yay. Bye.
Bye.